Hi children, welcome to today's science class. So we'll continue learning about how to be safe wherever we are. So in the previous class we saw how to be safe by following the safety rules at home and also on the road. I hope you all are started following that. So in today's class we will see how to be safe even when we are in the school. So to start this, we will have we will imagine a situation, children. Just to imagine that we all are in the school. Yes. So let us think that our class 3A and your teacher, myself, and we all are going round in the school. Yes. And you will be observing the different places in the school. So you are going to imagine it and you are going to tell me the different places we find in our school. Shall we start, children? Yes. So today we are going to learn about safety at school. So for as a part of that, first we will try to identify some of the places which we are familiar in our school. So first, children, yes, everybody's favorite, the playground. Yes, you all will be happy to be in the playground. And also the next comes your classroom where you will sit and learn, no, children? Very good. And also sometimes you will go to the computer lab for your computer classes. Yes, children. So I'll write computer lab where you will go for some classes. And also in this classroom only, various classes wherever you go. Yes, that is also included. And apart from the children, corridor is the place where you will walk. Yes, to go to different places. And then, children, yeah, you will be using the toilet also, no? So the toilet. Yes, children. And so this, at least five, we have so many other places out there. Just we will see these five places and we will try to do some activity with this. In your notebook also, the rough book what you are having, you can name these five places which we find in our school. You all have been in these places, whatever I have written. Now, children, you think and tell me one situation in this particular place. First place is the playground. Anytime, is there any possibility for an accident to occur there in the playground? Anytime, is there any possibility for an accident to occur? That's what you are going to say. Yes, accident can occur in the playground also, no, children? What type of accident will occur there, children? Yes, children. Maybe some children or yourself, children may get hurt, no, children? They may get hurt in the playground. And in the classroom, children, classroom also sometimes some accidents can occur. And there also same thing, children may get hurt. They may cry, they will be crying with pain. And computer lab, so why are you in the computer lab? When you want to reach the computer lab, you will be climbing the stairs. Yes, so when you are climbing the stairs, some may slip down. So on the stairs, falling down, simple words, falling down and getting hurt is also, is it possible? So here, classroom also children may get hurt. We'll see the reasons for that later. So in computer lab, when you are climbing the stairs, on the stairs, some may fall down and they may also get hurt. And corridor, children, corridor, is there any possibility of getting hurt? Yeah, there also children may fall down and they may get hurt. And what about the toilet? Anytime there also may any accident may occur. As already we learnt about the wet floor and falling on that in the safety at home. So here also there is a possibility of getting hurt. So in the corridor, children may fall and get hurt. Yes, this all you can, in a short words, you can write as an activity. And even in the toilet, same thing can happen. Children may fall and get hurt. See here, in all the situation, all the places where we enjoy learning and playing, suppose when we are, sometimes it may, there may be an accident also. Now you tell me, one by one you tell me, the playground is a place for doing exercise, doing yoga, playing and seeing the plants or planting, like that, such type of activities only should go on. Why children may get hurt there? What might be the reason, children? Just start thinking. Classroom is a place where children should learn and do some activities. Why there the children will get hurt? And in the computer lab, on the stairs, not only computer lab, when you are climbing up and down for various classes, attending various classes, why do the children fall down? Why some of them fall down? There is a possibility of falling down. Even the corridor also, why do few children sometimes, why that accident may occur? Why do we think that it may occur? Even in the toilet also, why do we think that the accidents may occur, children? Just you tell me, and one thing, all these reasons, why this will happen, children? Very good. When we are not following the safety rules. So now nobody wants this. No children getting hurt, crying. Nobody wants it. So let us see how can we avoid this. Yes, what we are supposed to do in the playground, children. So you are in the playground. So we don't want any accident. We don't want to get hurt. We don't want to get others also to get hurt. Yes. So nobody wants to hurt others and may give them pain. And we also don't want any pain and get hurt. So what we have to do when we are in the playground? Very good. Follow the rules of the game what you are playing and do not push others. This is very important. Just for fun also, please don't push others. And whatever game you are following, whatever exercise you are doing, whatever you are asked to do, follow the rules of the game. Then there will be no accident. Then in the classroom, children, what are you supposed to do? How can we avoid the accident? Do not run. Very good. At the home, how we wrote, same. Do not run inside the classroom. Jump on the desk. So many things we can add. You can write that. One only I am writing it. Do not run inside the classroom. Inside the classroom. Do not jump on the desks and benches. And also do not put your finger in there is also socket is there. We need lights and fans there. There also you cannot put your wet hands into the electrical sockets. Do not touch, don't play with the electrical switches in the classroom so that no accident will occur in the classroom. When you are not, this is not a computer lab alone, stairs, when you are on the stairs, when you are climbing the stairs, what you are not supposed to do? Do not, what children? Push others. Very, very important. If you push others only, they will slip down, walk in a line, and always maintain the discipline wherever you are there. So that in the stairs also, one is falling, she may fall on the other child, and 2-3 may also get hurt. It is not fun, no children. Getting hurt is not fun. So there also we have to follow the rules. And in the corridor you are going to some other classes. So how are you are supposed to behave? Do not run. Always don't be in a hurry. So that when you are running fastly, you will hit others and you may also get hurt and they may also get hurt. So to avoid that, please don't run in the corridor. You have to walk. Yes, walk. In the toilet, children, again, don't play with the doors. That is one thing. And also the floor is wet. So wet floor, you may slip down. So how you have to behave there? You have to be very careful. Yes, you should see whether the floor is wet. You should walk slowly. And also don't, even there fighting or pushing others, do not follow that. So for this, you can only write your own rule, how you have to behave in the toilet to avoid the accident. Not pushing others, locking the door when somebody is there, putting the latch outside, such type of things when you do, always it won't be simple. Sometimes it may lead to some complicated situation also. So when you follow the rules there also, we can be safe. Yes, children? Yes, children. So let us write what are the general rules. At least as I told you, at least 5 important rules we will try to write to be followed in the school. Just now we discussed the situations and now we will start writing. Yes? So first one is what, children? Do not jump on desks and benches. That is very important. Do not run inside the classroom. And when you are playing, wait for your chance in the slide or anywhere. Don't push others. Yes? do not push others. And this is do not push others, you can be written for the stairs also. When you are climbing up also, don't push others. Do not run on the corridor. Do not run in the corridor. So this may lead to accident and you may get hurt and you may make others also to get hurt. And follow the rules. Follow the rules of the game. Any game you are playing, when you are following the rules, definitely you won't get hurt in the, this is about the playground children. Do not jump on the desk and benches. It is inside the classroom. Even here you can write, do not run inside the classroom. Wait for your turn. Do not push others. This is also in the playground children. Playground. Do not run in the corridor. Follow the rules. This is also in the playground. When you are in the playground, you are supposed to follow this. And apart from that, very important here also, don't play. With electrical switches. In the classroom also, you have electrical switches. When you go to computer lab, there are so many electronic equipments. Please don't try to play with them, so that it may also lead to some severe accident. This is a very good quality, waiting for your chance and not making others to push and falling there, so that they may fall down. So when we are following this, we can avoid the accidents in the classroom also children. In your textbook also, you have some pictures related to that. You can see that and you can learn what are the points given there. So now as usual, we will see what is given in our workbook children. So let us see what is given in our workbook. S3, safety on road. Sorry, safety on at school, page 23. You please take it children. Write the date. Which safety rules apply in your neighborhood playground? So when you are in the playground, neighborhood playground, now you are at home, no. So which rules will apply here from this, whatever we wrote? Can you write one rule? Wait for your chance and don't push others. Very good. And next children, follow the rules of the games. Any game you are playing, you have to follow the rules of the games. Two are here only, and one more you can think when you are playing in the playground, nearby playground, what are the rules to be followed. So here you can see, wait for your chance and follow the rules of the games is there. And these two you can write, and one more you can think on your own and you can write. Any one particular game also you can choose, and how to be followed you can write children. Second question. Describe an accident that can take place, in your school toilet. Make a safety rule that can help prevent it. So in your toilet, in that school toilet, what kind of accident can take place children? Can we, just now we discussed, no? What type of accident can take place in the, maybe you can expect in the washroom children? Yeah, so now we are doing S3, please write the date. And first one I said, you can do on your own. 1, 2, 3 rules you can do on your own. Second one, describe an accident that can take place in your school toilet. Make a safety rule that can help prevent it. So one accident you can write, the floor in the toilet will be wet. Yes, if we run inside the toilet, we may get hurt. Yes, so this is one situation I wrote. You can write anything also, what any other situation, what may happen in the toilet, and you want to write one rule. So for this rule, what you have to rule, what rule you can write for that? Do not run inside the toilet. And if suppose so much water is there, you inform the adult so that they will try to wipe it also. Yes, no children. Third question. So this rule you only make. Third one. You see some children trying to get ahead of their of other children on the slide. So they are pushing one by one. What will you do? So what will you do? What you have to ask them? Ask them to wait for your chance. Do not push others. You can request them to wait for their chance and not to push others. What we can say them to do? I will request them to wait for the chance and not to push others. So when this is, if you request them or you bring it to the notice of other adults also, they will take care, or else the children who are playing there may get hurt. So again I repeat, safety at school, first one, rule 1, 2, 3, so many we discussed. So in among that, which is applicable in the playground, because playground children may be, fun sake, they will be running here and there. What can be done to prevent accidents? You can write children on your own. First one, let it be, do not wait for your chance, is always very good to follow any type of game. And also next is following the rules of the particular game, and never you should push others, even in the playground also. It's simply pushing for fun also should be avoided. So that three can be written, and second and third I hope you can do with the help of what we have discussed now. And apart from this children, there is one other part of this lesson, that is being safe during an earthquake. First of all, you should know what is an earthquake in detail. Actually, you are going to learn in block 24 about all the natural calamities, but now you have just today we want to give you some idea about how you can be safe during an earthquake. Earthquake is a sudden wild shaking of the earth, children. Suddenly the earth will shake violently. It is one of the earthquake. First of all, what is earthquake? Earthquake is suddenly, violently, not very mildly, violent shaking. The earth will, we are on the earth, no, when the earth itself is shakes, it is so difficult for us to be safe. So violent shaking of the earth is called earthquake. So suddenly, suppose you are in a building and the earthquake occurs, how you can prevent yourself? That's what some rules we will see in detail. Some of you are going to learn in block 24 after some time. So when suddenly if you are there and the building is shaking, so due to as the earth itself is shaking, the building may, the things on the building all may fall down. So what we have to do, always is safe to be under, in your textbook also picture is there, under a bench or under a desk we have to go and sit for, so that nothing will hit your head. Please, you should not go near the windows, you should not go under the fans and lights, because they may, the building itself will start shaking, so that anything may fall down on your head. So to prevent the head attack, so you should try to be under a desk or bench. If suppose nearby any open place is there, you are able to move out, that much time is there, mild wind starting only, you can run to an open place. But you are there inside, suddenly it started violently shaking, better to be under a desk or bench and wait, because shaking won't be there for so long time. So after some time the shaking will stop, then you can come out, or you have to wait for the people, rescue people, adults will come and take. And never you try to go near the lift and all, because everything is going to shake, it is going to be very dangerous. So what is an earthquake? Sudden violent shaking of the earth. This is the various reasons are there for the causing of earthquake. You cannot predict also. If suppose in your building, where you are, if suppose you feel that mild shaking is there, the best thing is in your textbook itself, the picture is there, you can see how the child is sitting under the desk. This is the best way to prevent yourself not going near the windows, because they may also fall down and you may get hurt. So these are all things you have to avoid. In detail about this earthquake, we will be learning in the block 24 children. But by now you should know at least 2 to 3 rules to be followed during an earthquake. So that is what, one is hiding under a bench or desk and moving to open place. This is only when it is possible you can run to an open place, and do not go near windows. Yes, because they may fall down. Even under the fan and all you should not go, that may also fall down. So about this in detail we will learn. That's why this much only I'm just leaving it. So you concentrate on safety at home, safety on the road and safety at school. So at school and road you can, and even at home also, there are so many possibilities of getting accidents. So it is very interesting topic to learn. So earthquake we'll be learning later. So these three you concentrate and learn for each one, 5 safety rules perfectly with proper spellings, and also complete S1, S2, S3. S4 you don't have in this block. So these three you complete, learn very well, and in A4 sheets you can write and practice it. With pictures you can paste safety rules, traffic rules, and send me the pics to it. Before the next class, be ready with completely learning up to block 12, children. Let us meet in the next class. Bye bye, children.